I blame Cheryl Connor and her article in Forbes for my predicament. She broached the question, what is authentic content and why does it matter so much? Now, I can't stop thinking about it. You'll find a link to her original article below. Last time, I suggested my first rule for authentic content is clarity. It must communicate to everyone consuming your text, graphics, video, and audio. In my view, that means stripping it of buzzwords and needlessly lofty verbiage as much as you can. Cheryl's first rule is any brand's journalism should be clearly identified. So let's start at the beginning. What is brand journalism? I found one definition for brand journalism that I liked. Brand journalism can be defined as using the credibility and influence of news to tell a corporate story in order to achieve competitive differentiation. It marries journalism with the core elements of strategic PR and marketing communications, visionary planning, research, incisive messages, and a defined purpose. I paraphrase this from the College of Business and Public Policy at the University of Alaska, Anchorage. So, brand journalism is another form of PR, marketing communications, or even, dare I say it, advertising. As such, Cheryl believes this intent must be clearly stated, especially when your content appears on someone else's website. Certainly, no one would complain if you advocated for your company on your company's website. In my mind, this goes back to my first rule of clarity. Revealing your intent is part of clarity. Trying to fool people into a business relationship is a bad idea in any era. In the internet age, with its instant critique and communication, it can be fatal. Cheryl's next two rules are authentic content must be truthful and acknowledge any bias. Again, here, if you're going to be clear, you're going to tell the truth. Clarity demands truthfulness, and if you're found to be shading the truth too much, the internet will call you out very publicly, and that genie's hard to get back in the bottle. As for bias, we all have them, and they are unavoidable. In fact, many are quite helpful. I myself have a bias against dying by being run over by a train, so I'm very careful at train crossings. To date, I've never once died in a train accident. I have been hit by a car driven by a friend who wasn't paying attention, but that only resulted in my being tossed harmlessly, if irreverently, into a snowbank. The biggest problem with bias is we oftentimes get the idea our biases are pure and others are not, which leads to a host of problems. But at its core, a bias is a point of view, and you should be able to clearly show why you hold your particular point of view without vilifying those who don't. In this way, your bias can work for you and not against you. Again, revealing your point of view aids in clear communication. Agree? Disagree? Let me know. You can follow us on social media, leave comments on the blog or YouTube, or send an email to the address on the screen. Thanks for watching. Now get out and do something.